a YouTube user from the Netherlands who goes by the handle AWE130 has now made over 80 moon hoax conspiracy videos where he shrouds his moon hoax claims under the guise of questions to NASA. One of his videos, which he uploaded on November 12, 2010, is called Question, NASA, Apollo 8. In this video, he shows an outtake from an interview with the Apollo 8 astronauts where they mention Dr. James Van Allen, whose cosmic ray experiments aboard Explorers 1 and 3 led to the discovery of charged particle radiation trapped in the Earth's ionosphere, now known as the Van Allen belts. Ah starts by suggesting that this excerpt somehow pits the Apollo 8 astronauts against Dr. Van Allen. Notice the little message that will appear at the top of the screen in which Ah says that this cut was made by NASA TV, not him.
But interestingly enough, all the scientists and Dr. Van Allen was convinced that we got fried going through his ionosphere belt. This, not the doctors were going nuts and we wanted, as if we they couldn't decide whether or not they were going to abort the mission. They didn't have much to say about it, really.
Frank, I have to tell you this right now, but we were going to the moon regardless of what happened.
Exactly.
As with most of Oz's videos, it is unclear exactly what message he's trying to get across, or what his question really means. To figure out his intent, you have to look at his comments. Ah claims that this video was evidence that Dr. Van Allen was convinced, after 10 years of study, that the astronauts would get fried while attempting to transit the radiation belts. The Apollo 8 astronauts apparently admit that Dr. Van Allen and all the scientists and doctors were going nuts. But when was that exactly? When did they go nuts? Was Dr. Van Allen waving a red flag before the launch? To figure that out, you have to view a part of the astronaut's interview that Ah doesn't show us in his video.
About two or three. I might as well get this out of the way right now because it'll come up sooner or later.
And it came up.
I began to feel funny.
I'll tell you, it wasn't a bit funny.
You know, Jim Lovell and I had flown for 2 weeks, and I'd never gotten sick. I'd never been sick in an airplane, but I really wasn't feeling too good. And so I managed to throw up all over him. And that caused great consternation back on Earth when Anders wanted to squeal on me. I wouldn't let him. So finally he dumped it on the tape and they read about it. And then
8 hours later, I covered his tail for 8 hours.
But interestingly enough, all the scientists and Dr. Van Allen was convinced that we got fried going through his ionosphere belt. This, not the doctors were going nuts and we wanted, as if we they couldn't decide whether or not they were going to abort the mission. They didn't have much to say about it, really.
Frank, I have to tell you this right now, but we were going to the moon regardless of what happened.
Exactly.
Borman's words were that Dr. Van Allen was convinced that we got fried, past tense, going through his ionosphere belt. The medical doctors went nuts when they found out that Borman had vomited because nausea and vomiting are the early warning signs of radiation poisoning. The doctors were considering turning the spacecraft around to bring the astronauts back to Earth and begin radiation treatment. Dr. Van Allen's concern was that his 10 years of research wasn't good enough to ensure safe passage to the moon. And Ah's poor attempt at quote mining could not convince a third grader that in December 1968, before the launch of Apollo 8, Dr. Van Allen thought the astronauts could not maneuver around his ionosphere belts, and they would be killed attempting to fly to the moon. Sorry, Ah. Better luck next time. Ciao, moon hoax conspirators. Wherever you are.